What up, y'all? This is J. Cole. Cole World. My voice is gone. What can I say, man? It's the first night of the Cole World World Tour, Vancouver. I lost my whole voice, man. But in other news, we got good news. You are now tuned in to Hip Hop Canada. What's better than that? I don't know. Cole World, September 27th. The sideline story.
Something like them 10.
We just wanted to know what we can expect from your new release when you release it in September.
Yeah, just expect like evolution, expect man, my voice. But expect a lot of stuff. Like it depends on if you heard the leaks. But I got a song called Lost Ones. It's like an incredible story. A lot of emotion. Like there's people that listen to that song, they might cry when they hear the song. Cause you know, it's that intense or whatever. So there's other songs like that on the album as well. My voice is crazy right now, but there's other songs like that. There's that emotional and that intense that even me, and I made them, when I listen to them, when they done, I'm like, whoa, like it feels like I was on a ride. So you can expect that. You can expect some fun records like Can't Get Enough, which is with Trey Songz, a couple other things. It's a good balance, but it's really strong, like production, lyrics, concept, stories. Really strong.
Do you think that there's something that you are trying to prove to your fans? Are you like, are you reaching out to do something for yourself? Like, what is it with your success that you want to do?
I don't know. I just wanted to do the music that I believed in. So a lot of that spilled into the mixtapes because. You know, I didn't have an album out, you know, and I needed to put out material to gain fans, so a lot of that music spilled out into mixtapes. I Get Up, Life's Please, Enchanted, Farewell, all these songs that I threw on mixtapes were actually songs that to me were always album worthy. So that's all I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to continue that and put out music that makes people be like, whoa, I don't want to put out mediocrity or mediocre songs. I want to put out the best songs that make you feel the best. So if it's an emotional song, I want you to feel a lot of emotion. If it's a fun song, I want you to feel a lot of fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just want to do, I want to be the best, period.
With Lights Please, you portray a certain type of female character who's somewhat naive.
Yeah.
Right? Do you feel like you come across that type of character quite often in your career or in your life?
I feel like you can. It's funny because that song ended up being like a metaphor. It didn't start that way, but it turned into like kind of like a metaphor for. So not really females. At that time, yes, I did feel like that because that's where I was at in my life. I was also like super righteous. Like I was always into politics and reading, and I was all about like what's wrong with the world. That was my main focus. Which is still there, but I'm not as intense with it. Like, I'm a little more happy about life or whatever. But no, with Life's Please, it's funny because it ended up becoming a metaphor for, like, hip-hop and hip-hop fans. So I have my fans that love my deep material. Then you got, like, other hip-hop fans who, like, they're not trying to hear that. They don't want to hear that. They want to hear this. They want to hear, you know, the club music or you want to talk about money and bitches and whatever, which is cool. Cause I do that too. But it's like, almost like they have, those people have become the girl that I'm talking about in Life's Please. You know what I'm saying? Where it's like, I'm trying to put you on some other shit, but all you want to do is this bedroom shit, freaky shit. And it's like, all right, well, I can do that too, that's cool. But I wish you liked that more. Like, I wish you wanted to talk about real shit more. So like, hip hop fans, well, not my fans, but the large majority of the fans, like the world is more like that girl.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But it's a slow process. It's like fooling them. You know, if I give them what they want and then give them what they need, it's like tricking them. It's playing the game to change the game. It's like fooling those people.
How at such a young age do you come out with such swagger? Like, you're quite the confident young man, you know, and since your first release, you've been that way. And you seem to know quite a lot about the world, so. Where do you think this confidence flows from? Like, who gave that to you? Where did it come from?
I don't know. I think it's just kind of just on the go learning. Because I wasn't 5 years ago, 6 years ago, I wasn't this kind of, I couldn't get on the stage and do that. I almost had to fool myself into doing it. Like, you know, when I got on stage, it would appear as confidence, but it wasn't. And eventually it turned into that. So I don't know if I always had that. It's just kind of grown as time went on. I always had the confidence in the music, but not necessarily in how I perform and how I present myself to people.
In your song, Losing My Balance,
mm-hmm.
You touch on a lot of issues like insecurity and love and stuff. Where do you find your balance these days? I mean, you're in a crazy world right now, so where does your balance come from?
It is tough. I just always gotta keep adjusting. So like, it comes from friends, from you know, my real circle of people that I keep around me, it comes from them. And staying attached to them. But it gets tough, I'm not gonna lie. It always takes a constant readjustment, you know, because I'm always out on the road, I'm always in the studio. So it takes a constant readjustment so I don't go nuts, you know what I'm saying? It's tough, I don't necessarily know the answer to that, but I know I'm always adjusting somehow, like whatever I need. If I need to have a conversation with my mom, then that's what I do. If I need to have a real discussion with my friends about something and get some clarity, then I'll do that. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's it.
Right. So your core beliefs are important to you, obviously.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I know you're a big college advocate.
Yeah.
So I want to ask you what you think about Kanye coming out with an album called College Dropout, when he must be someone that, you know, you have listened to and a big influence in your career.
Yeah, I loved it. Even though I knew I wasn't going to drop out, I could relate to that feeling. I can relate to that feeling, which is like, what about no rules? There's no rule that says you gotta go to college, I gotta do this, and my heart is in this. So I was in college when that came out, I was a freshman. And I still, you know, of course, I loved it. I got one homeboy of mine, he was like, yo, nigga, y'all love that Kanye so much, he was like, I dropped. He was like, he made me drop out of college. It's so wrong. But he said he used to drive to school, and before his first class, he used to just sit in the car and play College Dropout. And it gave him the confidence to be like, I don't need this. Which you might look at and be like, well, that's bad. But I look at it like, you know, if that's what he believed in, and he felt like his heart was somewhere else, then that's cool. And then he went on and he got in the music game, and now he's doing his thing. But it's just funny how dope that concept was.
Kanye's pretty good, but pretty I want to know, are you the best? Are you the best in the game right now?
Right now? I'm always the best. I don't know if the world knows that, but I feel that way. I always feel like I'm the best. You know, I might not have done the things to prove it yet. You know, like if I'm in the NBA, I can't say I'm the best if I don't have a championship ring. You know, but in my mind, I believe that I can't make a case against Jay-Z, you know what I'm saying? You know, of course not. Or Kanye, or Lil Wayne. But in my head, I'm always the best. And it's always my goal to prove it. You know what I'm saying? So I understand I haven't proven that to the world, but in my head, it's still like that.
Yeah. I'm the best. Well, hey, straight up, I tell you, I just really want to cut. We'll be together. Oh, oh, oh. Come here, girl, let's get it on. Hey, straight up, now tell me, do you really wanna love me forever? Oh, 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 or is it just a hit and run? Well, straight up, I tell ya, I just really wanna cut when we together. Oh, oh, oh.